Hey, welcome back. Today we're going to be putting together the YZ80 forks, shorten. I'll show you what I made up. And the rebuild kit that I'm using. This is a Pivotworks rebuild kit. That's the part number. So, getting down into the meat of it. This is the cartridge rod. I looked at doing this a few different ways. This is probably the easiest way to go about this. This is just a piece of nylon that I turned and drilled, so it's like a loose fit on there. You don't want it to be dragging on the shaft. And this length is basically how much you want to shorten it by. And similarly, you don't want it to be tight on the inside bore of this. So if you can find like a piece of PVC pipe or something, you could possibly make something that could go on there. But so you just slide it together in between the washer and then your spacer and then the top out spring. And then you put the valve back on the bottom. So I'm gonna assemble one of these legs just to show how it goes together. The torque specs you can get, if you can find a service manual, it shows you how to take the legs apart. I'll see if I can dig some up and maybe even put them in there. So the kit comes with, these are the outer dust seals. These are the lower leg sliders, and we have upper leg slider. We have the inner oil seals, new crush water washers for the bottoms of the fork leg. So these guys are right here. And new O-rings for the top here. So next we are going to reassemble the cartridge washer, spacer, top out spring. I gave the rod a quick polish. Mine got a little bit of surface rust on it just from sitting with no oil on it after I'd put them through the parts washer. That was my bad. So next up is the installation of the needle, which goes this way. Goes assembled into the tube like so. And then this gets threaded on. Clean these threads off with a little bit of cleaner. I would recommend putting something like a blue Loctite or something on there. So I have a little bit of Loctite stick. Just apply a bit to the threads. Not too much, you don't want it to get all over everything in there. Then you're going to take your clamp block and go to the vise, clamp on the shaft, tighten that down. So now that you have that tight, this is assembled. Similarly, we will put a little bit of Loctite on here. We will thread this together. we'll just use the screwdriver trick on the bottom with it clamped on a rag in the vise. Snug that up tight. So next up, show a quick clip of me shortening the springs. It just involves basically cutting them off on a cutoff wheel and then using a torch on a heated plate to flatten the end out and then grinding it on like a belt sander or something. So yeah, I'll just show that really quick. Then we'll jump back into the assembly. The length that you want to try and hit is going to depend on how big your spacers are, but you want to leave a little bit of preload. You don't want the spring to be loose. You want the top cap to go in with just an amount, a slight amount. So you're better to err on the side of like adding in like a eighth to a quarter of an inch to the length overall than you are to make it too short. Next up, we can put the spring perch, rotation perch back on. There is a small indent in one of the arm, one of the sides that's supposed to go into a groove, so just make sure you line that up. Lower cap out of the bottom of the leg. This one's being stubborn. So you have to remove this O-ring to remove the crush washer that we're going to replace that comes in the kit. So next is to prep the legs. Start by installing your outer dust seal. Wrap the upper part here with electrical tape to keep the seals from getting cut. These edges are extremely sharp. Then next up, you can put your clip on, but you can get it. You can put it on with it on thereafter, and then install your inner seal. Then your washer. Then you can put on the lower slider. A little bit of fork oil. You can also put fork oil on the tape to help the seal slide on, but this just helps lubricate everything. Then, lastly, the upper slider. Now, making sure that your leg is clean, you can lubricate the inside a little bit. And slide your legs together. Now you're going to need to use a seal driver. This is one that I made up, just out of some Delrin plastic, just a split driver, but you can also buy them. The tube is 36 millimeters, so if you were buying one, you'd probably want to buy one for 36 millimeters. So once that's seated, you can take your clip and install that. Then you can install the outer dust seal. So now you have your fork leg mostly installed, other than the cartridge. So I had set the cartridge aside just while I was doing that. So now it's time to install the cartridge. So just make sure your O-ring's installed, you have your new crush washer, your assembled cartridge with, you can take that off for the time being. You don't need the dampening rod in either if you're worried about it falling. You can put a little bit of fork oil on the O-ring. You should be able to actually line it up through the bottom. And then you can see the threads there. And then with that, you should be able to start the threads. Get the thing wound in quite a ways. Make sure it's not cross-threading or any of that sort of stuff. Then using this little impact on a really low setting, like the lowest setting it has, I think is about 14 foot-pounds. And the screwdriver trick, so just holding the teeth on the top of the cartridge. You can also make a PVC tool that would fit in there or something of that sort. So we're almost done at this point. We can install the dampening adjuster. We can install the spring guide bushing. We can install our modified spring. We can take our top cap with the steel spacer that it normally has. Before we install that, we can thread on the nut that everything locks into. So we need then a 17 mil wrench, and we can lock the top cap to the adjuster nut. And then when you thread this up, you can see how much shorter it is. So I haven't put any oil in it. Probably gonna have to play around with weights and volumes because we've changed the spring rate pretty drastically. We've chopped a bunch off of there, but that'll get you close. From there, you're gonna have to play with all the rest to try and see what's gonna work well for you. But that is a significantly shortened YZ85 fork. Well, that's it for me. Until next time, take care.